Streaming a LEGO build can sometimes lack the excitement of a gaming stream. That's probably a controversial statement to some LEGO fans, and building LEGO is very exciting in some ways, but I think you get the idea. I love watching trains. MonoTown, my LEGO city, has lots of trains, and monorails too. What if I could give Twitch viewers the ability to control trains within MonoTown? That would be almost too much excitement. We had to do it. After a bit of research, I had a plan. In 2019, LEGO discontinued their Power Functions line of infrared-based motors. The replacement line of motors and sensors, somewhat confusingly named PoweredUp, now uses Bluetooth. This would simplify the comms to the trains. I wanted a bot that would connect to chat via the Twitch API and listen for commands from viewers. When someone told a train to move, the bot would relay the command via Bluetooth to the LEGO trains. And, it turns out, someone had already taken a stab at connecting LEGO motors to Twitch, and their code was open source. The entire thing could run on a Raspberry Pi. I downloaded the software, connected everything, and it worked. One of the authors of the software even stopped by to see their work in action. It was great. Except, I wanted to be able to expand the project in the future. A few years back, I downloaded the phone game Fallout Shelter and quickly got obsessed. It's a resource management game. You build a vault and need to make sure that your vault dwellers have enough food, water, and electricity, which are all produced and consumed by different types of rooms. What if I could recreate elements of that game within MonoTown and have viewers play during streams? Trains would require electricity to run, which would be generated by windmills and consumed by factories and houses, among other things. MonoTown would come alive during streams and provide viewers a challenge. This meant I would need to write my own software to control the trains in MonoTown, though. I decided to use JavaScript and Node.js, mainly due to the excellent open source library NodePoweredUp that already supports pretty much every LEGO motor and sensor in the PoweredUp range. I connected to Twitch using the TMI.js library, and then it was a simple matter to wire things together. LEGO receiver boxes will hunt for Bluetooth controllers to pair with when they turn on, and they stay connected as long as the controller is active. This means that even over long streams that last a few hours, the trains will still operate just fine. I used the LEGO PoweredUp app to rename each receiver and then add that receiver to the list of trains viewers can control. To watch the trains, I added 4 different cameras around the city, with more coming, and set up a train hunter scene that gives viewers a way to see all angles at once. There are only a couple of places a train can hide now, and I can switch the scenes to follow the train around once it's running. MonoTown right now has one operating line, the lower level tram line, but will soon have 2 more elevated rail lines completed, meaning viewers will be able to run up to 3 trains at a time independently. What's next? Getting a prototype of the resource management game up and running, getting more trains running, and of course, more building the city of MonoTown. Join us during our live streams and get those trains running.